What's up? I'm Royce, and welcome to my channel where I talk about all things film and tech related. And today I got two more hubs for the Mac Mini M4 that I'm going to be talking about. And both of them are from the same company, Minisopuru, who's also the sponsor of this video. The first one is their Mini4Pro, and the other one is the 218 Mini B Pro. And even though this video is sponsored, my review and just general opinion will be my own, so I'm definitely gonna let you guys know honestly what I think of these two products. So first, let's start off by unboxing the Mini4Pro. And there it is. It's actually nice, it's small. It's got some nice weight to it. Now let's unbox the Mini218 Pro. Right here we have a thermal pad and a screwdriver, and here's the hub. Unlike the Mini4Pro, this hub is meant to put the Mac Mini placed on its side right here. So before I go any further, I do want to let you guys know that both of these are USB 3 hubs. So if you're looking for a hub with faster speeds, maybe with Thunderbolt for your Mac Mini, I don't think these are gonna be it. But they still have some offerings that I think are useful, so I'm gonna get into those now. Starting off with the Mini4Pro, it's got that nice square aluminum design to go with your Mac Mini M4. You can see there's this little loop cut out here to make space to access the bottom power button. That's definitely been a trend with a lot of Mac Mini M4 hubs that we've seen recently, as well with having a slot down here where we can install an NVMe SSD. Now the ports here, we have two USB-A ports that are USB 2.0. So these are definitely meant for plugging in those peripherals for say your keyboard, for your mouse. You don't have to rely on Bluetooth. If you have MIDI controllers, accessories that don't require fast speeds, this is what this is for. A full SD card reader and a micro SD card reader. Now, the only thing is the SD card reader is UHS 1, which will only give you about 104 megabytes a second of read and write speeds. On the back, we have another USB-A 2.0 port, a headphone jack, HDMI that does 4K 60 hertz, and the USB-C port that we would plug into our Mac Mini. And even though all the USB-A ports are USB 2.0, the NVMe SSD is USB 3, so you will get those 10 gigabit a second transfer speeds. And moving on to the Mini218B Pro, on the front, we have full SD and micro SD card readers. But same thing, it's UHS 1, so you're gonna get those 104 megabytes a second of transfer speeds. And then in the middle, we have a 10 gigabit USB-C port and two USB-A 2.0 ports for those peripherals. On one side, we have a headphone jack, and then on the other, we have another 10 gigabit USB-A port. And then at the bottom, we have that space to install the NVMe SSD. So these two hubs do share some similarities, but after going through all the specs, I would say the 218B Pro is actually more of a true USB 3 hub, where the Mini4Pro actually seems to be more USB 2.0 focused. So first, let's attach the Mini4Pro to my Mac Mini M4. It's not really attaching, but more so placing it on top, because it's not like this like actually snaps in or anything. If you hold it off to the side, like it will fall off. So just know that it's not meant to like snap in place, which is fine. But you know, they have that nice rounded cutout in a sense, so you know exactly where to place it. And on the back of it, we have the USB-C cable that we plug in to the Mini4Pro and then into our Mac Mini. The provided cable definitely sticks out quite a bit. So for me personally, I probably just get a shorter cable. So it's kind of more of a shorter loop here. That's just a personal preference for me. And there's that loop cut out for the power button. And before I actually set this up and then turn on my Mac Mini, let's install the NVMe SSD so we can check the speeds on there and see how everything else works. And now we're gonna take the cover off using the included screwdriver. And what's cool is it includes all the instructions right on it. So you don't have to say, come back to this video or check out another video to see how to install it. It's all right there. Also a nice touch is it includes the sizes of all the NVMe SSDs that can fit in here. So you have 2230, 42, 60, and 80 right there. I'm gonna be installing my Samsung 990 Evo Plus into here. All right, then we'll slide in the pad on top. Then push down, screw it back in. And there we go. Now that I have the Mini4Pro set up, I'm gonna turn on my Mac Mini. All right, so with these ports primarily being USB 2.0, really all that we can test from like a speed content creator standpoint is the NVMe SSD, and just to make sure that we are getting those full 10 gigabit speeds that are promised, also testing the SD card readers as well. So let's open up Blackmagic's Disk Speed Test app. If you're not familiar with this app, it is a great way to test your hard drive speeds to make sure they're working the way they should and to see what type of content, what resolutions and things your drives can actually work with. So I'm gonna point this to my NVMe SSD and hit start. All right, so we can see that we're getting around what we expect, 980 megabytes a second of write speeds, 839 megabytes a second read speeds, because 10 gigabits a second really taps out around 1,000 megabytes a second of read and write speeds. So these are the speeds that you would typically see. Let's test out the SD card readers, which again are UHS-1 card readers that max out at 104 megabytes a second. Now it's hovering around what we can actually expect, 100 to 102 megabytes a second of write speeds, and it'll be similar with the read speeds. So this is what I expected, but I will say it is disappointing that these SD card readers are UHS-1 versus UHS-2, which gives us 312 megabytes a second of transfer speeds, which for me, shooting on my Lumix S9, which shoots on an SD card, having that faster speed really makes a difference, especially when I need to turn around a video pretty quickly. Now we'll do the same with the Mini218B Pro. And to set this up, we place it on the side here and it just slides in like that. And we use the provided cable to then plug in to the back there. And kind of same situation with the Mini4Pro. The cable does protrude out a lot. You know, you can tie it up like this. It would have been nice again to have sort of that shorter cable to make this a little bit cleaner back here. You know, you could make the argument where if you wanted to take the Mac Mini off the hub, you know, you got some space to work with a little bit here, I guess, you know, to kind of place it somewhere else. But then that defeats the purpose of having this and it also being a stand for your Mac Mini. Yeah, I would say that would be my biggest note for both, just to have a shorter cable to keep the setup back here nice and clean. And of course, it being on its side, you also have an easier way of pressing that power button. And with both hubs, I didn't mention with the Mini4Pro, but both are designed to where they're, you shouldn't experience any Wi-Fi interference. And just like with the Mini4Pro, before we set this up, I'll install the NVMe SSD on this guy as well. Unscrew the top there. Dan has the instructions right here. That's nice. This one's a little different because we have these little holes here that we put this little rubber stopper that will help keep the SSD in place. I'm gonna take this one out here. Little rubber stopper all the way back here to fit the size of the Samsung 990 Evo Plus. Put this back. Bam. Now it's locked in. Then we'll put the thermal pad on top of the SSD and close it up.
So now I have the Mini218B Pro set up on my desk and I plugged in a bunch of things just to see what it would look like if I'm utilizing this hub to the fullest. So I have my Samsung T5 plugged into the USB-A 10 gigabit port on the side. I have my full and micro SD cards inserted into the slots there. I have my SanDisk Extreme Pro SSD plugged into the 10 gigabit USB-C port. And I plugged up these two peripherals here, just one for my wireless keyboard and another for my ASUS gaming controller, just so you can see what that looks like. And also, if I have my headphones plugged in into the headphone jack on the other side. So with this design, you can see why it'd be kind of nice to have the Mac set up on its side there, but with cables and everything kind of protruding out to the side, or which is the back of the Mac Mini, you can see visually it's not the cleanest look. But at least with this hub, you are getting two ports with those 10 gigabit speeds. And the reason why that's not that much of a big deal, especially if you're editing with, say, like a Samsung T5 or a SanDisk Extreme Pro SSD, you're only getting 10 gigabits out of those anyway, even if you plug them into the Thunderbolt ports in the back, because these are USB 3.2 Gen 2 SSDs, which Macs do not support. So that's why I say keep an open mind when it comes to these hubs that are marketed at 10 gigabit speeds. Yes, it may sound slow, but if you're not working with Thunderbolt drives and you're working with a lot of these USB 3.2 Gen 2 drives, those are being locked into that 10 gigabit speed. So it really doesn't matter. Let's open Blackmagic disk speed test. So first, I'm gonna point this to my SanDisk Extreme Pro. Hit start. So it's hovering around like 850, 860 megabytes a second write and about 850 megabytes a second of read speeds. So that one got 896. So yeah, pretty much close to that 1,000 megabyte ceiling that we're going to get with USB 3.1. So this is what I really want to hit home with you guys. If these are the drives you're editing off of, your SanDisk Extreme Pro, your Crucial X10 Pros and all that, and you're complaining about these hubs coming out that are only 10 gigabit speeds, those are the speeds you're actually using anyway. So if those are the drives you still want to use, there's still a lot of benefit for using these hubs to go along with your workflow. Because if you think you're getting those full 2000 megabytes a second that comes with USB 3.2 Gen 2 times 2, you're not getting that. You're not doing what you think you're doing out there. Now let's talk about price. And this is where things get a little interesting. Both of these hubs are $99 and they both kind of do the same things, but slightly different. The Mini4 Pro, I would say this is just if you have a lot of different accessories that you use and you're not really looking to get a hub to plug in hard drives or to deal with large files of media and things like that. But if you have to plug in for your keyboard or your mouse, or if you're working with like a MIDI keyboard, your producer, and it gives you access to headphone jacks on the back that you can plug into, you still need to have an SD card reader, right? So you have that. It's not going to be fast transfer speeds, but that's really not the purpose of this. It's really so you can have all your peripherals plugged in. You don't have to use USB-C adapters or take up ports from your Mac Mini. Also, if you're somebody that's looking to have a dual 4K monitor set up using the HDMI port, so you don't have to take up a USB-C port and do the USB-C to HDMI conversion, you can also do that with this hub. Have one HDMI cable come out of here and then another one come out of your Mac Mini for that setup. And again, it's just nice to have that little cutout for the power button. And yes, it would be nice if there was a Thunderbolt port to replace the one that you're taking up on the back of your Mac Mini, but this is not a Thunderbolt hub, so can't really expect it to have that. Whereas the Mini218B Pro, you can kind of do the same situation if you're somebody that needs the peripherals, but you don't need all three ports. You say you have two that you need to plug up there, but you are somebody who is working with larger files and need those quicker transfer speeds. And you got two ports. You got the USB-C port and you got the USB-A port. Now, same situation with the SD card reader, but it's a little bit more drastic on this hub since it is offering those faster 10 gigabit ports. It would have been nice if this SD card port was UHS-II for those faster transfer speeds. And again, it's not a Thunderbolt hub, so we can't get a port that replaces the one that we're taking up, but it would have been nice. And what's also nice is having that little spot here where you can place your phone. Now, in my perfect world, instead of these being two separate products, I actually would have tried to find a way to throw all of the features in the 218B Pro into the Mini4 Pro, because I am more of a fan of this design versus this one. Now, if the $99 price is a little bit of a concern, Minisopuru has provided me with a discount code that you guys can utilize, and I'll include that in the description. But yeah, let me know what you guys think of these two hubs down in the comments. But that's it for this video. Hopefully you found it helpful. If so, please like and subscribe to the channel. And until next time, peace out.